Hello all you YouTubers, welcome back to the second part of the Zooxanthellae transplant with a bleached Gigantea anemone. So one thing that got me to do part two of this video was my curiosity about how many species were there of Zooxanthellae and which ones would work with each anemone and which ones would not. And looking at this introduction, it says, over the past 25 years, the use of new molecular tools has led to the identification of 9 major clades. It goes on to say that with each clade being characterized by a considerable level of diversity. So when they talk about 9 major clades, with each clade being characterized by a considerable level of diversity, I thought, wow. And then I ran across my answer. It says intracladal diversity was then estimated using gene sequences, proposing that at least 160 distinct Zooxanthellae types exist. So then I thought, wow, 9 clades, and then we have 160 different species within a clade. That's 1,440 different species across the board. It says some species can host a number of symbiont types, and a single symbiont type can be found within multiple hosts. But do we really want to take that chance? And that led me to look at diversity of relationships from specificity to flexibility. Some of these guys are picking non-random relationships. Others that have a high degree of specificity for their host are referred to as ecological specialists, which then begs the question, to what extent then can depth, light intensity, temperature, latitude, and longitude turn specialists into generalists? So then I thought, wow, are these things like actually communicating with a host? Indeed, they are communicating. You have two different modes of transmission, horizontal, which is indirect from the environment, and vertical, which is direct from the parent, but yet you also have mixed transmission. So honestly, after reviewing all this data and looking at the studies, I just feel it best to stay within the species and not gamble and take that 50-50 chance of it may work or it may not. Because at the end of the day, I don't want to waste my time pulling tentacles off of anemones and it not work. So with that being said, let's go ahead and pull some tents off of Minh's gig. It's funny, this clown will host the gig at night, and then in the daytime he likes to host my purple Magnifica. All right, let me cut the lights on.